knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we discussed the types of sediment that cover oceanic crust. Now it's on to the crust itself. Beneath the sediment is a layer of rock called pillow lava. At mid-ocean ridges where new oceanic crust is made, molten lava erupts from cracks in the crust, where it almost instantly cools once in contact with the cold ocean water. The rapidly quenched lava forms pillows, or bulbous bodies, which can then break open and exude more hot lava from beneath the surface to form additional pillows. This process repeats over and over, forming a thick layer of stacked pillow lavas. The pillow lavas are often called pillow basalts, with the term basalt referring to the lava's mafic composition and fine grain size. Basaltic rocks typically lack visible crystals. Underneath the pillow basalt is a layer of rock called sheeted dikes. Dikes are a sort of underground plumbing system that bring magma from the mantle upward toward the ocean floor. They are essentially fractures caused by extensional faulting that act as magma conduits. Sheeted dikes are formed when the rising magma crystallizes within the fracture conduits, instead of extruding from the ocean floor to form pillow lava, and over time, clusters of basalt columns form, creating a sheeted dike complex that looks like a row of several meter long dominoes standing side by side. Beneath the sheeted dike complex is a layer of coarser grained igneous rock called gabbro, which has the same composition as the above pillow basalt. Gabbro has larger crystals because it cools much more slowly, as it is not near the ocean water. In fact, the gabbro layer is basically the crystallized remnants of the magma chamber that was responsible for feeding all the volcanism along the ridge. The upper portion of the gabbro has a uniform structure, while the bottom portion displays a layered or cumulate structure caused by dense crystals forming in the magma chamber and sinking down to the bottom. The basalt and gabbro of the upper oceanic crust is composed mainly of calcium-rich plagioclase feldspar, or CaAl2Si2O8, augite, or CaMgSi2O6, and magnesium-rich olivine, or Mg2SiO4. Finally, at the very bottom of the lithosphere is rock called layered peridotite. The upper portion of this layer is composed of crystallized ultramafic partial melts of the mantle below, called whirlite. This material represents the first and most undifferentiated magma created at the ridge. As magma rises, it cools and crystallizes out the most refractory minerals first, which causes the magma to change composition as it rises, becoming more felsic, or rich in silica. This process is called differentiation. Whirlite is rock that is composed mainly of augite and olivine, and as it rises, much of the olivine crystallizes out, leaving behind a more silica-rich melt that eventually forms the basaltic feldspar-rich pillow lavas of the ocean floor. Beneath the whirlite is another cumulate layer, or layer composed mainly of olivine crystals that formed in the whirlite magma chamber and sank to the bottom. Finally, at the very bottom is the unmelted residuum of the original mantle, which is composed mainly of the olivine-rich rocks Harzburgite and Dunite. The entire sequence of rocks that comprise oceanic crust, from the layered peridotite on the bottom to the sediment on top, is called an ophiolite. Ophiolite outcrops can be found in Greece and most notably Oman. The Somali ophiolite, which was formed along a 95 million year old mid-ocean ridge, is one of the largest and best exposed ophiolites in the world. As the ocean basin closed 80 million years ago, the entire section of oceanic crust was thrust onto the southeastern corner of the Arabian Peninsula during the collision of the Arabian and Eurasian plates. Ophiolites are typically the last sliver of oceanic crust that evades subduction and gets smushed between the two continents right before they collide. Today, scientists use the Somali ophiolite as a point of reference for seismic measurements of oceanic crust. So with that, we conclude a broad assessment of all the layers of the Earth. Now it's time to zoom in from this grander scale down to things that are much more familiar and readily observable. What are rocks themselves made of? Let's spend the next few tutorials answering this important question.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.